In this video, I will try to set up my new Arduino kit. First, I'm gonna connect everything and get it working. This is an Oled screen from the sensor kit. This board I'm gonna use later, not for this project. It is possible to connect different sensors, lights, ventilators, wheels to this board with these wires. And here is the board I'm gonna work with. You can connect it to your computer and upload any code that you want. I have never worked with Arduino before, but so far it looks really simple and intuitive. It has a transparent cover. And this is how you can connect it to your computer. It looks like I didn't plug it in properly. But anyways, you can see that the light is on. There is also an instruction in the box. I'm gonna be honest, I didn't read it and I regret it deeply. Let's go ahead and connect this wire to the screen. Wow, this sound is amazing. It's time to connect the screen to the board. It's pretty much intuitive. You have to match pins with the correct characters on the board. Here I had to spend several minutes to plug it in. I didn't think that my fingers are too big for this job. Okay, it's done, and now let's connect the power cable. I didn't have this sound before. So now everything is connected, and as you can see, nothing happened. It's time to read the documentation. Let's go to the website. Here I select the board that I have, click on tutorials, getting started. And here it says that I have to install some software. So I go ahead and install the version for my old Mac OS. When everything is installed, I have to do some settings. For example, select the board that I have in the top menu. Here I select Arduino Uno. Oh, it's already selected. And now I'm on the sensor kit website because I want to learn more about my screen, and looks like I have to copy paste some code. I've learned that Arduino uses its own coding language, which to me looks pretty much like C++. And because I have some experience with C++, these functions look really simple for me. Probably that's why I completely forgot to include the library. And now you can see that the first compilation was unsuccessful and I didn't get any results. I was asking myself why, and here is why. You just have to include the library. After installing a library, I had another compilation error, and that happened because I didn't specify a port that I'm using for my Arduino. Unfortunately, I didn't film that, but it's not so hard to do. And after adding a port, I was finally able to compile everything, and here you see how it works. First, I'm printing a random number on my screen, and because I'm currently learning German, I decided to print a second string. It says Hallo hin, and in German it means hi. And this is the result. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, hit the notification button. See you soon.